In the last set of slides, we analyzed how to handle a perpendicular polarized plane wave. Now let's look at a parallel polarized case. Parallel polarized means that the electric field vector can be drawn on the board. So here is an example of a parallel polarized plane wave. We can see, I draw a line right here, that this axis, this angle, theta I, so it shows up in this location. Let's figure out where the magnetic field is. Direction of propagation, electric field, the magnetic field should be out of the board. So here is H for the parallel polarized case. Now let's do the reflected field. The electric field vector does not change polarization. It comes like this. Here is the reflected electric field, and right there is the angle of reflection. The transmitted electric field also retains its polarization, up like this. Here is the transmitted parallel polarized case. Right here is theta t. Now let's look at the magnetic field for each one of these. The magnetic field for the reflected case, put your thumb in the direction of propagation, put your finger in the direction of E, the magnetic field has switched so that it goes into the board. Over on this side, direction of propagation, electric field, magnetic field, out of the board. So here is ht. Note that the direction of propagation for each of these waves is exactly the same way as it was for the perpendicular polarized case. So these vectors don't change at all. Our direction of propagation and the phase shift that we see as a result is going to stay the same whether the wave is perpendicular polarized or parallel polarized. Now let's write our vectors. Let's write the electric field incident vector. That is going to be E incident, which we'll assume is given, the magnitude. Now it is in the x and z direction. I'm going to use the same vectors that I did before. This is the z axis, this is the x axis, and the y axis is out of the board. So we take the magnitude, and then we need to multiply it by the polarization. So the polarization in this case is going to have an x and a z component. So let's write that. We can see that the x component is positive, and it is cosine of theta I. The z component is negative, and it is sine of theta I. So that's the polarization of the incident electric field. Let's write the reflected electric field. That's going to have a magnitude of reflection, and that's going to be, not surprisingly, the reflection coefficient for the parallel case times E incident, which is given. So there's our magnitude. And now let's write our polarization. The polarization here has an x component, which is cosine of theta I, and it has a positive z component, sine of theta I. Now let's go to the transmitted field. Just like before, our incident field and our transmitted field are the same, except for the angle. Theta I transfers to theta t. So this is going to be the magnitude of the transmitted field, which will be tau parallel times E x z incident. And then just copying this polarization down here, it's going to be x cosine of theta t minus z sine of theta t. So there's the polarization for each of our electric fields. Let's look at our magnetic field. Our magnetic field incident is going to be, let's leave this magnitude here, the polarization of this field, straight out of the board, is in the y direction. Let's look at the reflected field. Let's leave its magnitude. The reflected field is into the board, so this is in the negative y direction, and the transmitted field, leave its magnitude, is again in the out of the board, the positive y direction. So now we've been able to find the polarization for each of our magnetic field components.